So this is actually, I missed the morning. So I missed the part where we got to celebrate. This is an awesome new event for us. And we've been trying to really think about what research means to Red Hat in the Red Hat context. And a big part of that is collaboration and openness and trying to help our research partners in academia find ways to get code impacting upstream communities so it's not lost into, not making an impact where the communities are moving relatively quickly. And most of that is about software, but I'm an OS guy, and I'm actually really excited that right now there's this stuff happening in the industry that is about hardware. And I've been thinking about what does that mean? Why do we have all this hardware kind of innovation, proliferation of new ideas? The cloud is a lie. And the lie of the cloud was all CPU cycles are created equal. It's just compute, you throw your apps at it and everything just works. And that's kind of, there's an 80-20 thing going on there where, yeah, sure, for a whole broad set of general applications, that's totally true. But if you go to a public cloud provider today, I haven't counted them, so I'll make up a number. There's something like 100 machine types. And this isn't just small, medium, large, larger, even larger, 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 larger. It's fundamental different types of machines that are aimed at specific workloads. So it's either optimizing for large memory, it's optimizing for high IOPS for storage, it's optimizing for network. These are all there because that initial lie was that all applications are equal. And I think that's an important thing. We already knew that because we spend a lot of time optimizing platforms for applications pre-cloud and kind of got lulled into this complacency that everything is sort of symmetrically equal. So I think there's a number of things that are happening besides the lie. And that is the kind of pithy, you know, the world's coming to an end, laws of physics are, you know, Dennard scaling or Moore's law, depending on where, how you want to define your view of computing, is going to hit some fundamental physical challenges. I think that's true. You look at how you increase the number of transistors and CPU clock speeds, and you start having these liquid nitrogen-cooled beasts that just aren't normal. It's not how people are going to build data centers. It's really expensive. It's cost prohibitive. We have the explosion of data that's really not just in terms of the number of sources, but the types of data that we're collecting. It's expansive and continuing to grow. And networking topologies are changing. And you'll see 5G bring devices closer to the edge of the network in terms of latency. So there's all these things happening, I think, at the same time, which is fun because it means hardware is changing. I was talking earlier at lunch about what does it mean to have all of these systems evolving where we don't really have a good picture of how they come together. So there's real implications at the operating system level, how you share memory. There's been a proliferation of choices, call them standards, of how you can do cache coherency between auxiliary processors and your host processor. And there's different types of acceleration techniques. There's specialized hardware. Think of an ASIC. There's programmable hardware, FPGAs. There's things that kind of bring them together, like a SmartNIC, where there's some fixed function, fixed purpose functionality as well as programmable functionality. There's different types of processing. So you have something that's really awesome at vector processing. Different core counts. I mean, there's a lot of different ways that this is coming together, and I think it looks like a very heterogeneous environment, heterogeneous computing environment. And so, hopefully, the rest of the afternoon, one of the things that you can be thinking about are what are the implications for computing, and what are we doing to build something? And what I was thinking, speaking with Arcady earlier this afternoon, was question to me was, what about the software? Well, that's a great question. And maybe we could take an analogy of risk with an expectation that compilers improve relatively quickly compared with basically a function-specific instruction set architecture. And maybe learn a little bit from what has happened in the past to where we're going in the future, and where software and generalized software evolve and make programmers' lives easier, and where function-specific hardware, maybe partly due to real physical nature of the universe, real hardware changes are just what we need to start adapting to. I have fewer answers than questions, and hopefully the rest of the afternoon we'll get some great insights from the rest of the team. Thank you.